please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Happy Friday, come school. Today is Friday, December 18th, 2015. I'm Bobby Lukashevitz.
And I'm Matt O'Connor, and it's time for KTV Live Tranquility.
So I see you have some antlers on.
So do you, Rudolph.
Yeah, it's a nice holiday spirit day.
Yes,
so
it is.
Just get right into it. Today's KTV holiday is Bake Cookies Day. This holiday serves as a reminder to bake holiday cookies. According to HolidayInsights.com, cookies are made in a wide variety of styles using a variety of ingredients, including sugars, spices, chocolate, butter, peanut butter, nuts, or dried fruits. The softness of the cookie may depend on how long it's baked. To celebrate this holiday, bake your favorite cookies and eat them with your friends and family.
Today's KTV birthday is Bridget Mendler. According to FamousBirthdays.com, she was nominated for a 2010 Teen Choice Award for Breakout TV Female Star for her superior performance on Good Luck Charlie. Bridget will be turning 22 years old today. She also starred in Lemonade Mouth and provided the voice of Throne on the video game The Great Cow Race.
Today starts Holiday Spirit Week. Today's Holiday Character Day. Monday is Holiday Pajamas. Tuesday is Holiday Hats. And Wednesday is Ugly Sweater Day. Be creative throughout the whole week.
Recently, a team in the NBA was on fire, winning game after game. But unfortunately, this had to come to an end. What team lost their consecutive win streak from the beginning of the season? Is it A, Brooklyn Nets? Maybe B, Golden State Warriors? Or lastly C, LA Kings? So I know that all these teams have had a pretty good season. This team was tied second for the most consecutive wins in the beginning of the season. And the answer is B, the Golden State Warriors. The original record for the most consecutive wins in the beginning of the season was set by the Los Angeles Lakers in 1972 when they were 33-0. The Warriors are currently 25-1 and are playing what already did play the Milwaukee Bucks.
All right, so you're here from me on all those sports today.
Yeah, if you didn't watch them, I can. So last night in basketball, the Hornets beat the Raptors 109-99.
All right, that's a high-scoring game. Yes. I didn't get to test that one, but that sounded like a good game.
Mm-hmm. Also in basketball, the Rockets beat the Lakers 107-87.
That's another high-scoring game.
Yeah, a lot of high-scoring games. And in football, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers lost to the St. Louis Rams 31-23.
All right, so that's a pretty good game. I didn't get to catch that last night because I had some homework and some other things, but
yeah, me too.
But sounds like a good game.
Mm-hmm. NJHS will be holding a holiday basket raffle in the cafeteria during lunch periods. Tickets are 50 cents a ticket, or you can buy 3 tickets for $1. The winners will be pulled on the last day before winter break. Buy your tickets today. So
it looks like we have a break in the show over there.
Yes, it does.
So let's just go check that out.
All right, so I am here with the registration form for the 2016 season of Clark Girls Soccer. It is Wednesday, October 21st, and Thursday, October 22nd, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. So make sure, if you want to play in Clark Girls Soccer next year, to hand in this form. So let's pass it back.
That was very informative. I know a lot of girls that would want to play that soccer, so.
Let's just get right back into it.
Yep.
This week, the 8th grade honors language arts classes went on a trip. They went to Lakewood Strand Theater and saw plays by Edgar Allan Poe, Washington Irving, W.W. Jacobs, Guy de Maupassant, and Mark Twain. There were two plays that these students read in class this year by Edgar Allan Poe. One was the Telltale Heart, and the other was the Raven. Miss Mayu stated that it was cool to see the books that were reading that. Miss Mayu stated that it was cool to see books that we read being acted out.
There will be a pretzel sale after school on December 22nd to support a great cause.
All right, so the weather
is... It's still kind of warm out, I'm assuming.
Yes, I'm not enjoying it because I'm looking forward to some cold weather, but I'm here to tell you about the weather for the next few days. So today it will be a high of 48 and cloudy.
All right, so that's getting a little lower than last week,
yes,
but still kind of high
for winter.
It's
pretty cool today, which I'm happy about. And tomorrow it will be a high of 43 and sunny.
Getting a little lower.
Yeah.
And I like the sun,
though. It's going to be a chilly weekend. And then Sunday it will be a high of 45 and sunny again.
That's nice also.
So it's still very sunny, which is good. And Monday it will be 55 and cloudy.
All right, well, at least I'm happy that there's no rain.
Yes, I mean, it's getting a little bit warmer, but I don't know. I still want cold weather.
All right.
Yes.
This week's theme is giving to charity. A recent study showed that giving makes people much happier. Let's see a video about more on that.
According to fMRI technology, researchers are able to see brain activity when certain acts of kindness are performed. In the study on giving, when people donated to a worthy cause, the midbrain region of the brain lit up. This is the area of the brain that is responsible for showing the link between giving and pleasure. Randomly assigned people were put into four groups that were to spend $20 on themselves or $20 on others. Those who spent $20 on other people reported being much happier, while those who spent money on themselves showed no change in happiness.
Since it is now the holiday season, it is a great time to give to charities for the holidays and make you and the people around you much happier.
There will be a yearbook meeting in room 18 at 7:40 on Monday, December 21st. All are welcome to attend.
You're on.
So,
I think it's already the end of the show, but I think we still have another preview on next week's shows.
Yes, we do.
Let's go see that out. Check that out.
Thanks, guys. So Monday's show is looking fabulous. We have a quiz on the NHL lockout, and we also have a graphic about the concert that was held last night. So that sounds very exciting. So let's pass back to the studio.
All right,
that was very informative. I mean, I can't wait till tomorrow's show.
Or Monday's.
Monday's show.
I hope I'm not coming to school tomorrow.
Stay here.
All right, so let's just wrap it up now. For even more KTV news, subscribe to us on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. For Matt O'Connor and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Bobby Lukashevitz. Have a merry weekend.